Good morning, everyone. Today we will discuss organotransition compounds with multicenter bonds, and our specific emphasis will be on butadiene complexes. So earlier to this lecture, we have discussed some other type of organotransition compounds which contain multicenter bonds. Like we have seen the metal alkene complexes, we have seen metal alkyne complexes, and metal allyl complexes. So in the earlier two cases, in metal alkene and metal alkyne, they were the dihepto complexes. Then in case of the allyl complexes, they were the trihepto ligands. And here in the butadiene complexes, the butadiene behave as a tetrahepto ligand. So this concept of hepaticity, it actually applies to those ligands which contain carbon-carbon multiple bonds. And in that case, since the pi electrons are delocalized in nature, so what happens when these pi electrons take part in the bond formation with the metal atom and a metal carbon bond is formed? So the pi electrons, since they are not localized in nature, so you cannot say that metal atom is attached to which carbon atom. So in that case, it seems like metal is attached to all the carbon atoms at the same time, and the number of carbon atoms which are involved in the bond formation with the metal, they are called as the hepaticity of the ligand. So if suppose in case of alkene complex, two carbon atoms were involved, it was dihepto ligand. Like three carbon atoms were involved, so it was a trihepto ligand. And here in the case of butadiene complexes, four carbon atoms are involved, and therefore they are called tetrahepto ligand. So butadiene also contain two double bonds, and these two double bonds, they both take part in the bond formation. So they have four pi electrons, and the four pi electrons are delocalized on four carbon atoms. The first compound that was prepared, the first butadiene complex, it was made in the 1930, and the name was butadiene iron tricarbonyl. It was prepared by the action of butadiene on iron pentacarbonyl, and pressure was applied. So this was a simple thermal synthesis of butadiene complex. The product obtained was a yellow-brown liquid. It was soluble in many organic compounds, and it was also found that it slowly oxidized by the air. So it shows the lability of the compound, and that could be attributed to the presence of double bond in the butadiene. After this discovery, many other transition metals like titanium, vanadium, niobium, chromium, molybdenum, these were also found to be involved in such type of bonding, and their butadiene complexes were discovered. And since the butadiene is behaving like a tetrahepto ligand, they are also called as the eta 4 complexes. So it was seen that these complexes follow EAN rule. It means that total number of electron in them, when you count the electronic contribution of all the ligands involved in the metal ion, in that case, it the sum of it should come to 36. So this was the case in the butadiene complexes as well. And we applied the EAN rule in the previous lecture when we were discussing the type of bonding in case of allyl ligand, whether it is a trihepto ligand or a monohepto ligand. So to find it out, we applied EAN rule. Now, let us continue with the methods of preparation. What are the common reactions which can be utilized for the preparation of butadiene complexes? So very first and very common reaction is a replacement of carbonyl from any metal carbonyl. So these common reactions are also used for the synthesis of metal alkene and metal alkyne complexes. When the alkene and alkyne, because they are so similar in their electronic structure to the carbonyl ligand, they easily replace it in the metal carbonyl, and as a consequence of this, you can prepare metal alkene complexes and metal alkyne complexes. So similar is the case of butadiene ligand, and here also the metal carbonyls can be used as a precursor. When it reacts with the butadiene, what happens? Butadiene replaces one or two or sometimes all of the carbonyl involved in the metal complex, and in that case a new metal butadiene complex is formed. So here the reaction condition could be photochemical or thermal. The reaction can be performed at high temperature and applying the high pressure. And similarly, the reaction can be performed at room temperature by applying the photochemical process. So here you can see two reactions. In both the reactions, you have iron pentacarbonyl as the precursor. And we have butadiene, which is reacting with iron pentacarbonyl. So when high pressure is applied, you can see that two carbonyls are replaced and one butadiene molecule is inserted inside the complex. This is eta 4 actually. So eta 4 C4H6, it is a triheptyl ligand and it is getting inserted in place of two carbonyl inside the complex, and we are getting a metal butadiene complex here. In the second reaction, you can see again we have a pentacarbonyl iron which is reacting with the butadiene ligand, but this time the reaction is taking place in the presence of ultraviolet radiation. So here the conditions are photochemical, and here the product formed is entirely different from the product that was being formed during the thermal reaction. So here you can see four carbonyls are replaced and we have only one carbonyl left inside the complex, and in place of these four carbonyls, two butadiene ligands were inserted inside the complex. So these two reactions are really important when you can change the reaction condition, and the nature of the product can be altered accordingly. Some more reactions are visible here, and you can see that this is again pentacarbonyl iron. It is reacting with this compound, and in the this part of the compound, you can see this is presence of two double bond alternate to each other, and this resembles the structure of the butadiene. So this part of the compound, it actually behaves like a butadiene ligand, and here a tetraheptyl complex can be formed with pentacarbonyl iron. So the condition of reaction is you are using the ultraviolet radiation here. Photochemical conditions are being used. So you can see in the two steps, these two parts will be getting coordinated with the metal complex. So in the first step, you can see one FeCO3 is getting attached to the butadiene. And in the second step, since this part of the molecule is also a butadiene, again, two alternate bonds are here. So this can also react with another molecule of the complex, and one more FeCO3 is getting attached here. So this is a very special type of reaction, and it is taking place under the photochemical condition. So you can see enhanced reaction can be observed when photochemical conditions are used. Now in this reaction 4, you can see again we have one unsaturated aromatic compound, and a part of this compound actually behaves like the ligand, the double bond, which can donate its pi electron to the metal atom. So complex formation can take place here. So here you have a nonacarbonyl di iron, and this can react with this part of the compound, and a complex formation is taking place. Apart from the iron carbonyl, we can also prepare the metal butadiene complex from other metals. Like here you can see we have molybdenum in both these reactions. So in one of the reactions, molybdenum hexacarbonyl, it is reacting with one butadiene, and two carbonyls are getting replaced. And in the second reaction, we have four carbonyl replaced by two butadiene complex. So these type of heteroleptic complexes can be very easily prepared by using this reaction, that is displacement of the carbonyl from any metal carbonyl by butadiene. Now in this reaction also you can see we have prepared the butadiene complex of rhodium metal, and by the similar reaction, that is displacement of the carbonyl. So this is actually again this is carbonyl, thrice carbonyl. So this reaction is actually very common, but we have another reaction by help of which we can prepare our metal butadiene complex. So this is the direct synthesis method in which we are using the metal vapors and these metal vapors are actually reacting with the butadiene vapors. Then what happens here? Then heteroleptic or homoleptic, both type of metal complexes can be prepared by these methods. So here you can see the chromium heteroleptic butadiene complex is prepared. We are also using carbonyl here along with the butadiene. In the second reaction, this metal could be molybdenum or tungsten, and they can react with three molecules of butadiene, as a result of which this will be three here. So metal thrice-butadiene, this complex could be formed. And again, you're getting a homoleptic metal butadiene complex by this reaction. Now, we are continuing our discussion towards the bonding and structure of such complexes. So here you can see the structure of the complex that was discovered in the 1930. And this was tricarbonyl butadiene iron. And this complex was actually synthesized for the very first time, and the structure determined was like this. The iron is attached to three carbonyl groups, three carbonyl ligands, and at the same time it is getting attached with one butadiene. So here you can see this dashed line is actually representing the delocalization of the pi electrons on this ligand. And since you cannot identify on which carbon these pi electrons are present, so you cannot also identify to which carbon this iron is attached, right? Since the electrons are delocalized, you can see that the diffusion, the overlapping is also diffused among the orbitals. And it is represented like this, that the iron is attached simultaneously to all the four carbon atoms. So therefore, these are called eta 4 complexes, where the hepaticity is 4 and your metal atom is attached to 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons at the same time. So such type of complexes are known for their hepaticity, and this is the example of tetrahetoligand or eta 4 complex. Now, if you look at the structure, you find that the ligand is in the cis configuration. How you can see that it is in the cis configuration? Because both the CH2-CH2 group, they are present on the same side. So the ligand is in the cis configuration here. The plane of the four carbon atoms is nearly parallel to that of the carbonyl group. And this type of observation is actually very much different when we saw the metal alkene complexes. In that case, the two carbon atoms, their plane is actually perpendicular to the plane of the other ligands in the same complex. But here, all the four carbon atoms, they are actually, their plane is parallel to the plane of the carbonyl groups. So the another observation made was the metal atom. It is equidistant from each of the four carbon atoms in the diene. So it is not that metal is near to any one of the carbon, rather its distance from all the four carbon atoms is equal. So this observation is very significant in this case. Like we are saying that metal is not attached to any one carbon, rather it is attached to all the four carbon atoms at the same time. So this type of observation actually support our theory, support our assumption about the structure of the metal complex, that metal is attached to all the four carbon atoms at the same time, distance equal in case of all the four carbon atoms, right? If there is a bond formation between the metal and any one of the carbon atoms, in that case you will not get an equidistant position of metal atom from carbons. So this is actually supporting our theory regarding the structure. And the second very important observation was the carbon-carbon bond length. It was also equal for all the carbons. So it actually says that there is no distinguishable single and double bonds in the molecule, in the butadiene molecule. Because if the double bonds and single bonds, they were separate, in that case you will get two different bond lengths for carbon and carbon bond. One for the single bond, one for the double bond. So if our observation is that all the carbon-carbon bond lengths are equal, it says that the bond is actually delocalized. Now pi electrons are not located to any of the two carbon atoms, rather they have delocalized over the entire system. And it says that all the carbons are actually participating in the bond formation. Now, if we explain the nature of the bonding in tetraheptobutadiene transition metal complexes, then we can do that by constructing the molecular orbitals of this system. So, as we know that this construction is actually done by the linear combination of atomic orbitals. So, what atomic orbitals we are taking here? We are taking a pz atomic orbital present on each of the carbon atoms. So we have four carbon atoms present in the butadiene. Each of them contains one pz orbital. And when they undergo the linear combination, then what will happen? After the linear combination of such orbitals, four number of molecular orbitals will be generated. Actually, the number of atomic orbital participating will be equal to number of molecular orbitals formed after LCAO. So we have four atomic orbitals, so we will get four molecular orbitals. Among these four molecular orbitals, two will be the bonding molecular orbital and two will be the anti-bonding molecular orbital. As we know that the bonding molecular orbital will be having a lower energy and the anti-bonding molecular orbital, they will have higher energy. So all the electrons, how many electrons we will have here in the system? We will have four electrons. So the four electrons of two pi bonds in the butadiene, they all will go to the bonding MO because of its low energy. So they will be present inside the bonding MO in the paired form. There will be no excitation of the electron until unless you are providing the photochemical condition. And therefore, in the grounded state of the molecule, all the four electrons, they are in the bonding MO, and this anti-bonding MOs, they are free. They are empty and they can accept the electron density from the metal. So there is a possibility of a back donation here. The d pi p pi bond that can be formed easily here. So here the combination of the metal orbital and the ligand orbital, it also depends upon the symmetry. Because the orbital that is donating the electron and the orbital that is accepting the electron, they should have similar symmetry. Here we have symmetry consideration. So energy level of these two, that is HOMO and LUMO, of two different reactants, that should be near to each other. Then only it is possible for the two reactants to form a bond. So it is the essential condition for a bond formation. So the four pz atomic orbitals on the butadiene, they combine and they give four MOs, and the orbitals of the buta 1,3-diene and the appropriate metal orbital. Upon which orbitals? The orbitals having same symmetry and they are in the same row. So we can also explain the structure and bonding by using the correlation diagrams when you are matching the energy of the orbitals present on metal and ligand both. So it is also a very important point that number of nodes is directly related to the orbital energy. So in all the cases, successively higher energy orbitals have molecular orbital nodes which are symmetrically placed and increasing in number by one in order of decreasing stability. So as you are increasing the number of nodes, you are actually decreasing the stability of orbital and you are increasing the energy of the orbital. So you can also determine the stability or the energy of the orbital by counting on the number of nodes present in the orbital. This is the diagram. Here you can see this is a correlation diagram. This side of orbital, it is representing the butadiene, and this is representing the metal orbitals available for overlap. So we have four pz orbital on four carbons. When they undergo LCAO, these two bonding and these two anti-bonding orbitals are formed. And since they are in high energy anti-bonding orbitals, they are not taking part in the bonding process. Rather, the electrons containing pi MOs, they are actually participating in the bond formation. So here we have psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4. These are interacting with the different molecular orbitals on the metal atom. So they will overlap according to their symmetry. So here in this correlation diagram, you can see that which of the MO of butadiene is similar in its symmetry and orientation to which of the metal orbitals. So this correlation diagram actually explains that the overlap between the MOs of butadiene and molecular orbital of metal atom, how it takes place. Psi 1 overlaps actually with S, P, X and D, Z square. Psi 2 is involved in overlapping with P, Y and D, X, Z. And the NTMOs, they are not participating here in the direct bond formation. Their energy correlation is also represented here with the metal atom MO. So these orbitals are important, and the geometry of the butadiene moiety is actually very well determined by the such overlap of orbitals. So as we have seen that these orbitals, these complexes are also following the EAN rule. So let us apply EAN rule on the butadiene complex. So again, we are taking the same example. This is tricarbonyl iron butadiene. So in this complex, you can see the electronic contribution of iron is 26 electrons. From butadiene, 4 electrons are contributed, and 3 carbonyls are donating 6 electrons. That means 2 electrons each. So when you add up these electrons, you actually get 36 electrons. So this is in well agreement with the EAN rule, and it also proves that 4 electrons are coming from butadiene. Therefore, it is a tetrahepto ligand. Now, if we take another example formed by the action of cyclopentadiene and iron pentacarbonyl. So, in this case, again, we have two double bonds alternately present to each other. And therefore, this part of the molecule can also behave like a butadiene ligand. So it reacts with the pentacarbonyl iron, and again a complex is formed in which we have 3 carbonyls, 2 carbonyls are replaced, and one ligand, that is butadiene, is attached to the iron. So you cannot say that which of the bond is near to it. Simultaneous bond formation with all the 4 carbon is taking place. So if you count on the EAN, so in that case iron will be contributing 26 electrons, butadiene 4 electrons, and 3 COs are contributing 6 electrons. So overall you are getting 36 electrons. So again, this complex is in well accordance with the EAN rule, and your butadiene, it is behaving like a tetrahepto ligand. Now what are the important reactions of butadiene? So we have 4 different reactions which are significant in case of the metal butadiene complexes. First is the substitution reaction. Then we have a nucleophilic addition reaction, electrophilic addition, and the last one is reaction of a substituent in the ligand. So first of all, we have a substitution reaction. In these reactions, what happens, the diene ligand is nucleophilically substituted. So the metal butadiene complex, it is actually containing the butadiene molecule in the bonded form. And we have seen that when any alkene, when any ene is attached to the metal, then the double bond character actually reduces, and it becomes what? It becomes susceptible to the nucleophilic attack, because the pi electron density is actually donated to the metal center. So here what happens, such type of complexes show a nucleophilic attack on the alkene molecule. So here FeCO3 and PPH3 twice, this complex is formed. The butadiene is actually replaced by 2 triphenyl phosphine. Now we know that triphenyl phosphine is very strong nucleophile, very strong ligand. And whenever it attacks on any of the complex, it actually displaces the carbonyl or the butadiene or any of the alkene if it is attached to the metal atom. So here the displacement of the butadiene takes place by a strong nucleophile. Then we have nucleophilic addition, which is actually the simple addition by the nucleophilic reaction of H minus, R minus, CN minus is cyanide, NEO minus, R3N, etc. These are the nucleophiles, and when they attack on the carbon of the olefin, that is the ene, so the diene ligand or any other ligand is displaced, or addition on the carbon takes place. either the displacement can take place, or if displacement is not possible, in that case these nucleophile get attached on the ligand molecule. So in this case you can see this is a palladium complex attached to the butadiene, and two chlorides are also present. When it is attacked by the Me2SO, what happens, the butadiene is actually replaced. Sorry, cycloocta-1,5-diene, it is replaced. However, it is behaving like a tetrahydroligand. So, therefore, this example is taken here. So, here you can see the displacement of the ligand is taking place. In some other reaction also, you can see that the addition of the ligand is taking place here. Rather the displacement, there is simple nucleophilic addition. So in both these examples, you can see the nucleophile is getting attached on the carbon of the alkene molecule. Third characteristic reactions for metal butadiene complexes are electrophilic addition reaction, and in these reactions there is addition of proton or elimination of proton. So proton can be added and it can be removed. Both type of reactions are possible. And here you can see we have the same compound tricarbonyl, and when it is attacked by the HCl, the protons provided by HCl, they actually protonate the molecule, and one of the carbon is now having one proton available, so it gets attached with it, and the CH2 is actually converted into CH3. So now this complex, which is containing the butadiene, tetraheptobutadiene, now it is converted into another complex which contains the metal allyl linkage. Now the butadiene is converted itself into the allyl group, and now this allyl is actually attached with the iron tricarbonyl. So this is the electrophilic addition reaction. Then the fourth category of reaction is a reaction of substituent groups. And the substituent groups, like here in this case, you can see the substituent, when the complex reacts with LiAlH4, which is a very strong reducing agent. So it reduces the substituent on the butadiene. So no change in the complex actually, rather the attack of the reagent is on the substituent present on the butadiene. So this reaction is when the substituent groups are actually reacting and there is a no reaction with the other part of the molecule. Now, similar to the butadiene, we have cyclobutadiene complexes. They are both the tetraheto type of complexes, but the only difference is in the butadiene, 1,3-butadiene, the molecule is a linear one, it is aliphatic, but in case of cyclobutadiene, it is a cyclic compound. So, in 1959, the first cyclobutadiene nickel complex was discovered. So this is the formula of that complex. And after that, a large number of complexes of transition metal with such ligands are now known. So cyclobutadiene nickel complex, it was first prepared by the action of dichlorotetramethyl cyclobutadiene with a tetracarbonyl nickel. So again, a carbonyl was used for the precursor. And when it reacts with the species, reacts with the ligand, then a heteroleptic type of complex is formed. So it was obtained as a polymer, like you can see here the dimer unit of the complex. So it was actually obtained as a polymer in which chlorine atom formed the bridges. So let us see the structure. This was the structure of cyclobutadiene complex. So this was a substituted cyclobutadiene when it reacts with tetracarbonyl nickel. In that case, what happens? The dimer is formed. So here we have a nickel and two chlorines are actually bridging between the two nickel atoms. And the remaining part is what? It is a tetrahepto ligand. The cyclobutadiene behaving as a tetrahepto ligand. All the four carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, and here also 1, 2, 3, 4. The four carbons are taking part in the bond formation. So it is very clear from the formula of this compound here, NiCl. One Cl is free on each of the nickel, and then two Cls are actually taking part in the bridge formation, and two cyclobutadiene, they are actually present on the each of the nickel atom. So in this manner, a dimer is obtained. And this was the structure of each dye. Now, after that discovery, many other cyclobutadiene complexes were known, and among them the unsubstituted pi cyclobutadiene iron tricarbonyl. It was prepared by this reaction. So the precursor was nonacarbonyl iron, and when it reacts with the cyclobutadiene, what happens? A compound which is very much similar to that of the butadiene complex, it was prepared. And it is a direct synthesis method. The iron is directly combined to the four carbon atoms of cyclobutadiene. And the structures are given here. All the four carbon atoms, they are equidistant from each other and from the iron atom. So all the carbon-carbon bond lengths are found similar, 1.46 and 1.46 angstrom. Similar palladium complexes were also synthesized for the tetraphenyl cyclobutadiene, and they are the analogous to the nickel complex that we have just seen. And the complex preparation was done by reaction of the diphenyl acetylene and palladium 2 chloride. It reacts with a wide range of metal carbonyls and pi cyclopentadienyl complexes, transferring one C4 PH4 group to another metal. So this is a cyclobutadiene which is containing four phenyl groups on four corners, and when such ligand reacts with the chloride of the palladium 2 chloride, it actually forms this type of complex, that is C4PH4PDCl2 and the whole twice. So the structure of this complex is very much similar, like we have seen here in the previous case, like we have seen here, the structure is similar. And when such complex react with this other metal, other organotransition compounds, in that case cyclobutadiene molecule is transferred to the other complex. So the palladium is actually transferring its ligand to the next metal atom, which is reacting to it. Like here in case of this reaction, the transfer is taking place from palladium to the cobalt. Now, other butadiene complexes are also prepared by the similar reaction of acetylene or cyclobutadiene derivatives or metallocyclopentadiene. So similar reactions have been seen, and the complexes have been prepared in the case of molybdenum and chromium. The difference is here we have four carbonyl attached to the metal and one cyclobutadiene is attached here. So such complexes are also prepared. Similarly, here you can see we have a substituted acetylene molecule reacting with the cobalt complex of cyclopentadienyl, and it combines with two molecules of acetylene, forming cyclobutadiene together. That is C4PH4, and again this is an example of a tetrahepto complex of cyclobutadiene. In the next reaction, you can see this type of compound can also form the cyclobutadiene complex with the iron carbonyl with the subsequent removal of CO2, and you can call it a decarboxylation reaction, where one of the carbon is removed from this ring and the cyclobutadiene moiety is attached to the iron in the form of a tetrahepto ligand. Now let us see the bonding and structure in these complexes. So the X-ray diffraction studies of the complexes of methyl and phenyl substituted cyclobutadiene, they have found that the C4 ring is square planar and the substituent are slightly displaced out of the plane of the C4 ring on the side remote from the metal atom. So if you look at the bonding between the metal and cyclobutadiene, the carbon atom of the cyclobutadiene, they are all in the same plane, but the substituent, they are directed away from the metal atom, out of the plane of the four carbons. Now it has been conclusively shown that the complexation with transition metal cyclobutadiene assumes a square configuration like this. So a square conformation can be confirmed here. Now, the free cyclobutadiene molecule in their square planar form, it will have two electrons in psi 1 and two electrons and only one unpaired electron in each of the psi 2 and psi 3. So, these are the MO of the cyclobutadiene and their electronic configuration. So, in the first diagram, you can see this is the square structure of the cyclobutadiene, and in the B, it is a rectangular cyclobutadiene. So, actually, the electronic configuration is determined by the geometry of the molecule. So, this will further decide which orbital of the cyclobutadiene will overlap with which of the metal orbital. So, the complexation of cyclobutadiene with the transition metal, it can take place when both the metal and ligand, they have similar energies along with the matching sign of their wave function. And on the complexation, the cyclobutadiene ligand, it assumes a square planar shape accordingly in order to make the overlap more effective. In these complexes, the electrons are accommodated in the molecular orbitals arriving from the psi 2 and psi 3. And if this retain actually the ligand character to a high degree. So, the four-membered ring that is ligated cyclobutadiene, it should be considered as a six-electron aromatic system rather than a two-pi-electron aromatic system. And the reason is simple that because it is assuming a planar structure, so it becomes now an aromatic structure. Therefore, the overlap between the metal and the psi 2 as well as the psi 3 orbital, it contribute mainly to the bonding in the complex. So this you can understand by this diagram. These are the four coplanar MOs of the butadiene ligand, and on to which metal orbital they can overlap is shown here, just like in the case of cyclobutadiene. So because they all are having the planar structure, now this becomes an aromatic structure rather than a polyene structure. And therefore, effective overlapping takes place according to the symmetry and orientation of MOs present on metal atoms. Now, what are the reactions of such complexes? So, these complexes are very labile and therefore they cannot be isolated independently. So, when they are released from their captive traps, they actually react quickly to any other reagent available, and therefore their free existence is really very difficult. So these highly reactive molecules, they rapidly decompose, they can dimerize or they can isomerize, or otherwise if there are any organic substrate is available around them, then they react with that to generate some new novel organic products. So here are the reactions, like the cyclobutadiene is actually getting isomerization. Here it is again assuming the isomerized structure. And these are some other reactions in which the cyclobutadiene is changing its structure according to the atmosphere. So with different type of reagent, these complexes react, and accordingly the substitution is taking place on the cyclobutadiene. It actually depends to which type of compound it is reacting. So substitution is taking place on the cyclobutadiene ring. Again, here you can see substitution is taking place on the cyclobutadiene ring, and such type of reactions, they can be utilized for the commercial processes, for the industrial processes, for synthesis of many new type of compounds. Again, some interesting compounds can be prepared for such complex, from such complexes. So you can see here cubane like structures and Dewar benzene, they can also be synthesized by different routes. And several chemical reactions like this, they are available for such metal cyclobutadiene complexes. Now it is the quiz time, so that you can assess your progress in this lecture. So my first question to you, I would like you to note it down in your notebook. The simplest tetrahepto, that is eta 4 complex, is what? So you need to find out the answer that is to be written here in the blank space. In the second question, general methods for the preparation of butadiene complexes. So you need to write down two most commonly used chemical reactions for the synthesis. And my third question to you is, during the formation of diene complexes, diene system using its what type of orbitals, and it is making appropriate combinations to form dash, which combined with metal orbitals of dash to give complex compound. So find out the answers from the study material, and this is the end of today's session. This is the reference book I used for preparation of this lecture. That is all for today from my side. Thank you so much.